All right, I think one of the dishes here that kind of makes me feel all warm and tingly inside is our open-faced guajillo braised short rib enchilada. What I originally wanted to do was birria, which is a braised goat, and that's the hard sell. So I figured short rib, which is a lot easier of a sell, can have the same depth of flavor. So what I did was prepare it exactly the same way. I braised it for about 3 hours in dried chilies and chicken stock and onions and garlic. And then I kind of shred it up. And then with the braising liquid, I make a sauce out of it. And then to kind of make it all come together, I throw some goat cheese on there, some fresh radish and some micro cilantro. And it's all open face, so it looks real hearty and fresh and vibrant versus your typical rolled enchilada, which just looks like an enchilada. Well, annatto seed is basically this berry that grows on a plant, and a lot of the Aztecs used to use it as face paint or to dye clothes or different things like that. And it kind of has a citrusy flavor to it, and it's known as poor man's saffron, so it'll make your food a really bright orange vibrant color, and it adds a lot of depth of flavor. You mix that with some garlic and some onions and some orange juice and stuff, and you make a nice marinade out of it, and it's really good. Heat with chili is a little bit of a guessing game. Sometimes the chilies are going to be really, really hot. Sometimes they're not. And you never really know. The only way you're really going to know is if you just take a bite out of one. The best way to kind of mellow it out is cut it open, take out the seeds, and take out all the veins, because that's really the base of your heat. The actual flesh is going to keep it really more on the mild side, a lot more depth of flavor. I mean, I work with some really hot chilies here. I work with habanero, which is one of the hottest chilies in the world. And depending on how you use it, and of course, moderation is everything, but I tend to notice that the smaller the chili it is, the hotter it is. When I use dried chilies, most of the time I don't rehydrate them. What I like to do is maybe even toast them a little farther to get a little more of a smoky flavor, a little more of a pungent flavor, depending on what I'm doing. If I'm making a salsa for tacos, I'm probably not going to rehydrate them. If I'm making a sauce for enchiladas, I'll probably rehydrate them in some fashion, maybe in the sauce while it's reducing, and then kind of blend everything up. So it kind of depends on your application, but I would say majority of the time I don't. I tend to kind of dry them out a little farther.
Do you ever have a in the kitchen?
It depends on if you're doing a red mole or a dark mole, but most of the time it consists of some sort of peanut or pepita seed, which is a pumpkin seed, some sort of dried chili, whether it be guajillo or ancho or albo, and then majority of the time some sort of chocolate to kind of mellow it out and kind of bring it all together.